Okay, so once again, we're in our process of learning the game of Euchre. And in our process, we're learning all these little tiny games, and this game's called Trump. And the way we do is it's just like a follow suit, where we dealt out the five cards to everyone. We make sure that we have four cards at the end when we deal. I'm the dealer. The only big difference here is we're going to turn over the top card, and that suit, in this case, it's going to be clubbed, is going to be considered trumped. And Trump is the highest suit. So like a nine of clubs in this case would be able to beat an ace of hearts or an ace of diamonds or an ace of spades. Okay, so trumps are like the special suit. But with this game, we still have to follow suit. The whole concept of Trump, it introduces a whole bunch of different things that you, different ways that you can play the game. And this is a great thing about Euchre, is there's so many ways you can play your hand that it stimulates a lot of conversation. Like your partner's always gonna say, why'd you do that? Why'd you do this? You know, that's a good thing about having a partner game, is now you have someone that's gonna at least yell at you or say, nice job. So that you there, or you can strategize how to do things better. But this is where things get really nice. In this particular case, we're gonna say kings are Trump. And the person to my left, because they're to the left of the dealer, I was a dealer, they get to lead first. Now, we're going to, I set these cards a little bit special, and we're going to do something a little bit different here. We see that this person is, one thing, we talked about the advantages of being short-suited, right? So a short-suited has a lot of advantages, because once you take the first one, you drain all the other cards of that suit, and it makes it so that the other ones are better. A lot of times we said that we often want to lead with our highest card. You know, trumps are our highest cards, but you know, whether we lead them or not depends on the situation. If I had the ace of clubs, I'd definitely lead the ace of clubs. But you know, here I got some relatively low trump. So it's like, do I want to lead those or do I want to lead this ace here? And I'm gonna play out one particular scenario. In this particular case, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna play my lowest card. And the reason why I'm playing this particular card here is because I want to do something what I call sucking the trump out. It's also called making your aces good. It's called making your aces good because I have an ace in my hand. But the thing that can beat that ace, the only thing that can beat it, is a trump. So if I was to get rid of the rest of the trumps from everyone else's hands, now my ace is looking pretty good if I can control the deal again. And I played my lowest one so I can get all those clubs out there. Then hopefully the other cards, the other trump will be lower than this one, and I'll be able to get control of the game at one point, and now my ace will be very good. So once again, we're doing this we're leading trump to suck out the trumps from everyone else, so that now my ace is better than it was before. Whereas if the trump are out here, someone can beat us. For example, if I was to lead the ace, this person over here was to lead the ace right away, you don't have any diamonds, so you would be able to put the nine of clubs on there, and even though a nine is lower, it's trump, and the trump beats the ace. So this is one of the problems with not taking the trump away first. So instead, what we're going to do is this person is going to lead a trump suit, and in this particular case, you don't have a choice. Now this nine that was really good before because it got my ace, now it's nothing. And then our partner over here, well, our partner, they can put this on here. And actually this is probably here they have a choice. And this is where they have to take a little bit of a gamble. And you have to look how their cards are playing out. So in this particular case, if they play an ace, or if they play the jack, which is good enough to win, there's still a queen out there and an ace out there, or a queen out there that they can beat. They already know the king's already buried, so that's not in play. But the problem with playing this is a potential loser. So what this person is probably gonna do is play the ace. And that way they're sure that no one's gonna put a queen on top of it. In my particular case, I don't have any clubs, so I'm just gonna throw off. So I'm gonna throw off, it doesn't matter which one I throw off, really. Draw the diamond, just make the colors different. So here, this person over here won, and they're gonna pick up those cards. So now there's also something that you're not supposed to talk about your hands to your partners, but there are certain things that you can pick up on depending on how your player your partner plays. For example, I might say that I might think that why would my partner lead such a low card? Well, if I was thinking about it, I think, well, that person's probably has another trump in his hand. It's probably and probably has some aces in his hands too. So he probably has another trump in his hand, so he probably wants to drain all the other trumps, and he's probably looking for where that ace is at, because the ace is the one that can stop him. Come in, the king's over here. So you can, based on how people play, I can tell that this person is trying, their strategy is trying to suck the trump out because they probably have another high trump in their hand. So going off that, the person's going to collect the cards. I'm just going to play it back. So a lot of times with your partners, a lot of times what people do, even when they throw off, if I throw off a diamond, a lot of times I'm telling my partner, hey, if you get the chance to lead, lead a diamond. You're trying to get these little tiny hints during the game without actually talking, because you're not supposed to talk during the game about your hands. So in this case, I'm going to throw out this the spade, which is kind of worthless to me. And here, our person that started the game, now they have the highest card out there. Keep in mind, the ace is already gone from this trick over here, and our king was turned up over here, so we know what that's at. So right now, this is the highest card. And of course, you don't really have anything to play here, so you're just gonna throw off a card. Now, you counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So all six trump are now gone. And that makes it so that this ace is now all of a sudden really good. So you can play a queen of spades, perhaps. This person has to follow suit with their diamond. And notice that now we know that the ace of diamonds out, the king of diamonds out. So that makes this queen and jack really good now, because nothing's gonna be able to beat the queen, because the king's out. We already know the trump are gone, and of course the jack's gonna be good too. Look at that for a second. Think about what we said there. So we already know the trump are already gone, because if you're only playing the game, you want to keep count of all the cards that are being played, right? There's six trump. Got the ace, the king's over here, queen, jack, 10, and 9. All the trump are gone, right? So now I knew this ace was going to be good, because the only thing that can beat an ace is the trump, right? And what I'm looking for is, I'm looking for that king, and it turns out my partner actually had a king. So the diamonds, highest, second highest are gone. That means this is the third highest, because everyone has to follow suit. That's going to win. And of course, that's also going to win too, because no one else has diamonds at this point. Think about it. Look at it for a little bit. Okay. So at this point of the game, my team, we just took our third trick, right? So that is now at least 1 point. And because we are, as I already said, no one's gonna be able to beat these cards, and I'm leading. What I would do is I would throw in both at the same time. And then, of course, everyone else is gonna say, darn it, and the rest of the cards go in, because nothing matters, because nothing can beat these. No one has a trump, and no one has any diamonds that are higher than that. Because we took all five tricks, we would get. Or they would get 5 points. Can you see how the trump adds a lot more complexity to the game? And we could play the hand quite a bit different. But like I said, it really matters how you play your cards. And people always argue about what is the right and wrong way about playing Euchre. Now, that's the beauty of the game, it stimulates the conversation. If you're new to the game and confused, when you have a party and people are talking strategy, just ignore it. Just play your own thing. Just focus on knowing the game itself.